Due to a conflict with the British over an unlawful salt tax, Mahatma Gandhi led a nonviolent protest which helped Indians to regain the right to use and sell Indian-produced salt, re-establish independence from the British, and change the method of protesting around the world. The day was April 1930 when Mahatma Gandhi revolted against the British's salt law, which stated that no Indian could produce nor sell salt on Indian territory. The only way to obtain salt was to purchase heavily taxed salt from the British. Gandhi, born on October 2, 1869, was an Indian activist who believed in freedom and unity. His teachings were based around the nonviolent concept of satyagraha, or loyalty to the truth. Gandhi used many unique ways of protesting against the British peacefully. One of these ways was fasting. Even at a young age, Gandhi observed his father, Karamchand Uttamchand Gandhi's patience and mercifulness against wrongdoers, which influenced him to show kindness towards others. Gandhi went to the University College of London Faculty of Laws for college. He wanted to learn more about laws so he can become a lawyer and help the people of India. Later on, he goes to South Africa to show his first acts of civil disobedience as being a lawyer.
There is an unalterable law governing everything and every being that exists or lives. It is not a blind law, for no blind law can govern the conduct of living beings.
The march set off from Sabarmati, where Gandhi's ashram was located, with only a several dozen followers. They would have to walk about 240 miles to reach their destination, which was the coastal village of Dandi on the Arabian Sea. The journey was a long 24-day trek with many obstacles in the way, but with pure determination, Gandhi's followers kept on marching. Along the way from village to village, Gandhi gave speeches to the people to have hope. Many others were inspired, which led to the march consisting of tens of thousands of people, including journalists and political leaders. One of these people was Jawaharlal Nehru, who was the Prime Minister back then. He believed in Gandhi's teachings and followed his ways against the British as a good friend. Finally, after a long and treacherous journey, the marchers arrived at their destination. The people were overjoyed as Gandhi picked up their first piece of salt, starting their protest against the British rule. Many went to the sea and collected salt water to produce and sell salt. Even though this was a time of happiness and joy, horrible things still occurred. Gandhi and more than 60,000 of his followers were arrested and imprisoned, but Satyagraha still continued without him. In January 1931, Gandhi was released from prison and the British government concluded that this action was not something they could suppress or ignore. Later on, India's independence was granted on August 1947. And was free from the British's rule. Unfortunately, 6 months later, on January 30th, 1948, Gandhi was assassinated by a Hindu extremist. Even though Gandhi has passed away, his teachings still live on even to this day. Many famous activists and leaders, such as Martin Luther King Jr. and Barack Obama, were influenced by Gandhi's teachings of nonviolence. Gandhi's message of nonviolence has traveled all over the world. These days, when protests occur, the intention is usually to just get the message through without any harm.
I praise such courage. I need such courage because in this cause I too am prepared to die. But my friend, there is no cause for which I am prepared to kill. Whatever they do to us, we will attack no one, kill no one, but we will not give our fingerprints, not one of us. They will imprison us, they will fine us, they will seize our possessions, but they cannot take away our self-respect if we do not give it to them. I am asking you to fight against their anger, not to provoke it. We will not strike a blow. They may torture my body, break my bones, even kill me. Then they will have my dead body, not my obedience.